All right.
So, Laurel, Dominic, Wendell, you've outlasted 17 other people in the game, survived 39 days, you've dealt with switches and twists, there was Ghost Island and curses to reverse, but here we are. For the jury, it's a process of discovery for you to get all the facts so you can write the name of the person you believe played the best game and placed it in the urn that Dominic brought back from Ghost Island to finish out this season. I'm going to give you a minute to gather your thoughts. We'll get started. Okay, first portion of Final Tribal is the outwit part of the game. This is the social part of the game. Alliances you made, relationships within those alliances or outside of the alliances, any ethical or moral dilemmas, lines you might have crossed. Kellen, get us started with the social part of the game.
Hi everyone, congratulations on sitting there and not here. In some ways, we all envy you, and in other ways, I'm glad that I'm not the three of you tonight because of what might be coming your way. So I'd like to hear what your plan was coming in and how you thought you were going to play the game socially with alliances and relationship building. Laurel, do you mind starting?
Yeah, you know, coming into the game, I came in as an athlete and I planned to play a really physical, aggressive game. Unfortunately, I was on Malolo and I was put in a position where I was playing from the bottom from day one. And so I managed to use my social game to find a way to hang in there, vote after vote after vote. I aligned with two of the most powerful players in the game, so I didn't plan coming into this game for my game to be largely social, but it absolutely was.
Just for the record, I'll give you the credit. Not only were you Malolo and were down on numbers the entire game, you were the only one of the three on all four tribes. You were put in a harder social position, having to make new relationships, you know, every couple of days. But obviously you were just glued to the two of them, letting them pave the way for you to get to the end. But what?
Yeah, I just want to clarify. I don't think that I rode with these guys to the end. If you think that their moves were great, I was a part of all their moves.
What I was about to mention, we always felt like we had a little bit of power in this game because we could switch it up when we wanted to.
Yeah, I think they were flashier about it. I think they spoke more about it at Tribal, but they wouldn't be here without me. The Dez vote, for example. Dez came to me with a plan. I exposed it to save myself, to get myself one step further away from the chopping block.
Just putting one more person.
Get myself one step further away from the chopping block.
Just putting one more person in front of you is not really anything to brag about. I mean, you knew that these two were a huge problem that needed to be separated. You had the chance to make a huge move and to obtain power and to really switch the game up.
But I wasn't scared to make big moves. I was receptive to plenty of options. None of them were options that benefited me. With these guys, I was in the top of a majority alliance. I mean, I'm not dumb. I know that sitting next to these guys, it's the toughest competition out here.